Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is yet another one from my What I Ate This Week series, wherein I'm going to share with all of you what I ate for evening snacks this week. For me personally, evening snacks are the most difficult meals to make because I generally feel very hungry between 4 to 5 pm, so I want to eat something that's very filling. At the same time, I also don't want to have something super heavy because then I don't feel hungry for dinner and then I feel too hungry late in the night. So today's video is all about filling but not extremely heavy evening snack ideas. So starting with Monday, now this Monday was a different case because I was fasting because it was Savan Ka Monday, which is when I usually fast. So on the days when I'm fasting, my evening snack is also my last meal of the day. So this was like my evening snacks come dinner. And typically what I like to eat around this time is something like a banana or some fruit with some yogurt. So today I'm going to have some bananas, two of them I'm using because I was feeling extremely hungry. So I'm going to slice up two whole bananas. And then I'm going to transfer them to a bowl. Bananas are a great meal on days when you're fasting because they give you instant boost of energy. To this, I'm going to add some homemade dahi now because a lot of you gave me some really good suggestions. I'm now in a position to make my own dahi at home. And then I'm going to add some powdered jaggery. You can add some sugar or brown sugar or stevia as well, but I prefer the flavor that jaggery adds. So I'm adding a tablespoon of jaggery here. And then I'm going to mix all this up and enjoy my meal. This looks pretty bland and not as exciting, but I was fasting, so this is the best I can come up with. Something that's filling, gives me energy, and at the same time isn't too heavy. So now moving on to Tuesday, because I was super tired of fasting on Monday and eating bland food, I'm gonna have something extremely polar apart. So I'm having some cheese parathas. So for this, what I'm using is some whole wheat atta, which I'm going to roll into a flat base first, and then I'm going to use some cheddar cheese to stuff it. Honestly, for me, parathas are one of my favorite things to cook because you can experiment so much with it. While I'm stuffing some cheddar cheese here, you can experiment with stuffing the parathas with any vegetable you like or anything, even if it's not a vegetable, because you know, mostly whatever you stuff inside, it will come out to be tasting pretty decent. I have a lot of different paratha recipes with me, so do let me know if you'd like to see some of them in like a whole exclusive videos which is dedicated to just parathas. So once I've done with the stuffing of the cheddar cheese, I'm going to roll it out and make it into like a nice big paratha, and then I'm going to toast this on the tawa. So what I'm using here is cheddar cheese because that's all I had at home, but it's not the best thing to use when you're making cheese parathas. Using the regular processed Amul cheese cubes that you get in the market is the best flavor you'll get in the cheese parathas. So if you're replicating this recipe, make sure you use that instead of using cheddar cheese. So at this point my parathas are ready. I'm going to transfer this to a plate. I've made a whole lot of them here because I'm going to share this with my sister-in-law who's also at home. Generally she's busy around this time, so she skips her evening snack wala meal, but today because I was making cheese parathas, even she was excited about it. So we're just going to have some cheese parathas with some yogurt, and yeah, that's what we had for Tuesday. Now moving on to Wednesday. On Wednesday I had my favorite smoothie of all time, and you guys have to try this out at least once. So in a blending jar I'm going to add about 200 milliliters of milk, to which I am going to add one whole banana. If you like, you can add two bananas as well. It completely depends on how hungry you feel at that time. Next I'm going to add a tablespoon of unsweetened cocoa powder. You can add the sweetened one as well if you like, but for extra sweetness I am adding two whole dates here. Now I'm going to blend this up into a nice smoothie-like consistency, and the delicious smoothie will be ready. Honestly, you guys have to try this out at least once because it is so tasty and so healthy and so yummy and so filling, and at the same time something that you will want to have every single day for breakfast or for evening snack. So I'm going to transfer this to a jar. And then before I have my smoothie, I always like to top this up with some ground up cinnamon powder, but this is completely optional. You can absolutely skip this step and the smoothie is still going to be as tasty. So yeah, this is what I had on Wednesday. Now moving on to Thursday. This Thursday I had some Indian style macaroni pasta. So for this, first thing I'm going to do is boil up some macaroni. So I'm using about a liter of water here. which I am going to put up on the gas stove, and for seasoning I'm going to add a whole lot of salt. And once it comes to a good boil, I'm going to add about a half a cup of macaroni pasta. The macaroni that I'm using is made with semolina suji instead of maida, so that makes it way healthier than the maida pasta. Now while the pasta is boiling, I'm going to chop up some vegetables. Honestly, I'm not using any vegetables here. I'm just chopping up some onions and some tomatoes because they are typically the ones that give the best Indian flavor to the macaroni. So I'm going to chop up the onions and tomatoes into small dices. And meanwhile, the pasta is also completely boiled and has come to like an al dente texture. So I'm going to drain the water out. And the macaroni is ready to be made now. So on the same pan, I'm going to add a little bit of oil, to which I'm going to add the onions. Next, I'm going to add a tablespoon of minced garlic, and then I'm going to saute all this together. Next, I'm going to add the diced up tomatoes. And for seasoning, I'm going to add some salt. Be mindful of the salt you add because there's already salt in the pasta, some red chili powder and a little bit of red chili sauce. I'm also adding some red chili flakes for extra spice, but this is optional. If you don't like your food spicy, you can completely skip this step. Now I'm going to mix all this up, and once the onions and the tomatoes are completely cooked and come to like a mushy consistency, I'm going to go ahead and drop in the macaroni pasta. Once you add the macaroni, make sure that you don't stir it very hard because chances are that the macaroni might break. So just give everything a light stir, make sure that the masala mixes well with the macaroni. And then I'm going to add some cheese because cheese makes everything amazing. Now I'm also going to toss the cheese gently with the rest of the macaroni, and the pasta is completely ready. I'm going to serve this in a plate and enjoy my meal at peace because honestly pasta is my favorite and I don't like being disturbed when I'm enjoying my favorite meal. Now moving on to Friday. This Friday I had something that was definitely not the healthiest but is super delicious. It's a peanut potato sandwich, and you have to give this recipe a try as well. So I'm going to start off with poking some holes in potatoes and rinsing them under the water. Once the potatoes are completely rinsed up and free of all the dirt, I'm going to add about a liter of water, some salt for seasoning, and I'm going to put them up for boiling. I just need to boil them for about 2 to 3 whistles in the pressure cooker. Once the potatoes are completely boiled, I'm going to take them off the gas and peel them off to remove the skin of the potatoes. What we need is the beautiful white part of the potato to make the sandwiches. I generally do this step as a part of my meal prep, but the last week I didn't do any meal prep, which is why it's taking me so long to make every meal this week. Okay, so when the potatoes are all peeled up, I am going to add some peanuts here for dry roasting. I'm going to dry roast them on a pan for about a minute, and then I'm going to transfer them to a grinding jar. Here I'm going to make them into a fine powdery consistency in the grinder. Something like this you can see here. And then now we're all ready to start making the potato filling. So I've added some oil to a pan, and then I'm going to mash up some potatoes for this. I'm going to add the mashed potatoes to the oil. And then for seasoning, I'm going to add some salt, a little bit of red chili powder, and I'm going to mix all this up really well and ensure that the masala gets coated nicely on all of the potato pieces. At this point I'm going to add about a tablespoon of the peanut powder. You really need to add a little, as little or as much as you want in this, but honestly adding as much as possible adds a lot of crunch and a lot of delicious flavor to the potatoes, so make sure that you're generous with your adding of the peanut powder. And then while this is cooking on the side, I'm going to prep up the bread. So I'm using two whole wheat bread slices on which I'm adding a layer of Greek yogurt. Greek yogurt is a great substitute for mayonnaise whenever you want to make sandwiches. And once this is ready, I'm going to transfer the peanut and potato mixture to one of the bread slices. And then I'm going to add some cheese on top because, as I said, cheese makes everything amazing. Now I'm going to add the other slice of the bread on top of this and add it in my toaster and griller for grilling. Grilling this sandwich literally takes about a minute's time because everything inside is already cooked. So in about a minute, this is how the sandwich looks and it's completely ready. So I'm going to transfer this to a plate. And I always like cutting the sandwich into two pieces because it's way easier to eat this way. And I'm going to serve this with some delicious mustard sauce. And yeah, with that, my meal for Friday is also ready. I am telling you guys, you have to give this a try because it's so delicious. So yeah, that's it for today. I've given you 5 delicious recipes for evening snacks. Make sure that you do try them out and leave me in the comments below how you like them. If you're new to this channel, please make sure that you subscribe and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!